Today, your questions answered, the things you want to know to really grow your YouTube channel. Hey everyone, what is up? My name is Tim Rose, and on this channel, my goal is always to hit my mark and to help you hit your mark on YouTube as well. If you're new here, welcome. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell notifications right now. Okay, so we're just jumping straight into the content today. You know, that's what you guys are here for. You want answers to these questions. You want to know, what do I have to do to grow my YouTube channel, to stay consistent, and to really help you become efficient and figure out those things? And that's what this channel is all about. So we're going to jump straight into the questions today. And the first question is actually coming from a longtime subscriber of mine called History Explained. And I've got to give a special shout out to my friend here because this guy has been with me since very early in my channel. And if you go to History's channel, he is not that old himself, and he's only made a handful of videos, but he is one of those really exciting content creators that only makes a video once in a while, but when he puts out the video, it's such good quality that he's literally attracting thousands of new subscribers with every video. It's kind of mind-boggling, and he's only put out 5 or 6 videos now, and he's grown to about 12 or 13,000 subscribers. And I remember even a couple months ago when he posted his first video back in a while, it was crazy. He grew by like 6,000 subscribers or something like that in the span of a couple weeks. So kudos to you, my friend. And your question today is, do you think that the algorithm treats bold titles differently? And am I using a different font? And that is an awesome question, my friend. I think that the algorithm can definitely treat those videos differently in the sense that a bold title, when you're using that on your channel and you know, you're making your title really pop out. I actually started doing that recently after seeing a good friend of mine seeing his video mentioning it. And my good friend that did that was Ethan King. And Ethan was talking about, you know, bold titles and how it really stands out. And I thought, oh, that's so smart. And in his video, he had actually mentioned a website, which is excellent. And that's what I've been using to do this. It's totally free and it's called LingoJam. And essentially all you're doing is taking your title, copy pasting it into the actual Dropbox that I'm going to actually show you on the screen, and then it spits it out the other side and gives you a whole bunch of different font choices to choose from. Now what's really cool about this is A, it's free, and B, you can actually on that site create your own custom font as well if you want to. It probably would be a little bit of a time-consuming endeavor, but it still would be something that would be well worth doing. Now, what I would suggest is that you test this out and see if it actually makes a difference for you. I will say for me, once I started doing this about a month back, I've gotten quite a number of comments from people who have actually mentioned how awesome the bold title is and how they found it really popped on the screen for them, and it just made them want to click. So in the sense that the algorithm would treat it differently, it's potentially, it could. If more people are clicking and your click-through rate is a lot higher, and I will say, like with my new thumbnail design as of late and my bold titles, my click-through rates have been a lot better. One thing I've been facing that's been a challenge is for me is YouTube is not promoting my content as much right now. I have seen a bit of a decline, but I know a lot of people have seen that. I've had a lot of people coming to me saying, like, I'm getting way less views, my views are way down. And it's happened to me too. And I'm sure it's happening to a lot of content creators. It's one of those things now, a lot of people are getting back to work. You know, there still is a lot of people home from jobs with the COVID and the pandemic and everything that's going on, but it's one of those things where less and less people are spending as much time on YouTube. That doesn't mean that there aren't still tons of people watching. It just means that it's natural, you know, it's a natural decline for a lot of people right now. I wouldn't worry too much about it because YouTube kind of goes in waves as well. And I know from conversing with a lot of larger YouTube content creators that I've spoken with, they've talked about the same thing. Even as a large channel, they'll have waves that go like up and down. And for a month or two, they're just like, they seem to be skyrocketing with views. And then all of a sudden they get a month or two where like they're getting way less views, even though their content is just as good and they're putting out regular content. So YouTube is one of those things that just, you know, it has its natural ups and downs. So if you're experiencing a down period right now, like, don't be distressed about that, okay? I don't think the font that I'm using has a specific name. It's just I choose it out of the list, the same one every time, because I always like to have kind of a nice, crisp, clean, bold looking font. But you can choose anything you want. If you don't like any of the ones to choose from, you can just simply create your own custom one right on the LingoJam website. So that's an awesome question, my friend. I thank you so much for asking it. And the next question is coming from another subscriber of mine who's been around for a while now and has asked some great questions. And that's my friend Sandy Patrol. And Sandy asks, does advertising my channel on Discord help me gain subscribers? And where else can I advertise my channel besides Discord? Well, Sandy, that is a super question too, my friend. And I would say that advertising your channel on any platform has advantages and disadvantages. Okay, I've actually tested out a few different platforms, a few different styles, a few different things to see, is one way better than another? Is one gonna get me tons of new subscribers? Is one gonna get me more views? What I will say is that I personally believe that the absolute best format for you to go with advertising your channel, and we're talking about paid advertising here, and there's lots of free advertising you can do yourself on any forum or platform online. But in terms of paid advertising, you want to do a Google ad or a Google sponsored ad, or whatever company you use, you want to make sure that they actually create Google ads. And there's a big reason why, and I'm going to reveal that in a moment, but essentially, you're advertising your channel does not in any way, shape, or form guarantee that you're going to attract tons of new subscribers. Case in point, so last year I ran an ad on, not an expensive ad, but an ad on one of my videos. And that video has now gone on at this point to be a very good performer for me. However, at the time, the actual ad itself brought me in, I would say, I believe it brought me in about 2,000 or maybe 2,200 views on the video, which is awesome. But in terms of my, and the retention was good, but in terms of my actual new subscriber count from it, I think I only gained maybe like about 15 or 20 subscribers. So we're not talking like, you know, a really high success ratio with that. Okay. Now I also have tested out an ad for a video of mine on Facebook. I wanted to see, does Facebook advertising, does it make a big difference? The same cost for that Facebook ad as the Google ad would have cost brought me in, instead of 2,200 views, brought me in about 110 views or 115 views. And I think I maybe gained one or two subscribers. So it was kind of, from my standpoint, a failed experiment. It just didn't bring me, you know, it wasn't worthwhile. I could have done the Google ad on it through another company, or if you know somebody who can create really good Google ads for you, they can be quite successful. The Facebook advertising, personally, I didn't have a lot of success with it. I know some other people probably have, and I think it depends on your niche, your genre, what you're presenting as well, the audience you're targeting. There's so many variables that it makes it really hard to know exactly what's the best, right? So that's why you, depending on your channel, depending on you, your personality, you have to test out the different platforms and the different formats and see, you know, does this work for me? Nope. Okay, let's try something else. Is Facebook working? Nope. Let's try, you know, Google Ads. And is Google Ads through this company working? Well, I got a lot of views, but I didn't get very good retention. You know, you got to look at all the different variables, right? And you also want to make sure you're using like a legitimate company too. So I'd love to hear from all of you guys, because I know some of you have used the same platforms that I have, on what your experiences have been. Okay, drop your comments below. Let me know, did you have success with Sprizzy? Did you have success with ViewRocket? Those are two that I've tested out to see what happens. And I would say in terms of the actual retention and views, my personal preference was ViewRocket. Sprizzy, I've only done, I think, about 4 videos in total with an ad just to test and see. The first Sprizzy campaign I did was quite decent. The second one I did was brutally bad. The video had a 6% retention. It was terrible. And then I tried ViewRocket, and I've tried Facebook as well. And the Facebook, personally, I would stay away from, but that's just me. So besides advertising in these avenues, because I know you were specifically asking about Discord, I have seen some people who've had some success on Discord as well. Personally, I think, I haven't tested it myself, but I personally think it would be akin to Facebook advertising. You may hit on the right group of people, you probably won't. So it's a question of, you know, you want to get those quality views, you want to get those people, but you want people who are going to stick around and actually watch more of your content. Now, I'll tell you the reason why I believe that Google advertising, Google AdWords, is the best. So if you use Sprizzy or ViewRocket, they actually set up the ads for you through Google Ads. So that is a big advantage. And the reason is because I have actually come to believe that YouTube will reward your channel and your videos if you use their advertising. Think about it. It makes perfect sense, right? You're paying them for an ad. They're gonna promote your video. And I'm not just talking about that specific period where your video is being promoted. Once it's finished, it doesn't just magically stop and that's it, there's no more views. I'm talking about like in the long term, I believe that the algorithm will actually register and recognize those videos that you've run your Google Ads on and will continue to push and promote them as you go and as you grow. So, and why I believe this is because a couple of my most successful videos that are two of the videos that do the very best for me day in and day out now, I advertised on like a year ago, and I've checked my analytics, I've looked at my metrics, and I've seen YouTube is promoting those videos consistently. They're getting lots and lots of daily views. Now, lots for my channel, because it's not a big channel, is, you know, maybe 10, 20, 30 views consistently. But if you think about it, imagine 15, 20 views every day. You're talking 500, 600, 700 views a month, just continually building up. So you can do the math once you, you know, attract many, many thousands or hundreds of thousands of subscribers, your channel can really start to steamroll. So I believe that YouTube will come in and reward you on those specific videos and promote your channel more if you do advertising through them. So I would stay away personally from the Discords, the Facebooks, or any of the other third-party websites and stuff. Your best avenue that I believe is going to be doing Google advertising. If you want to do free advertising, Sandy, you can do that anywhere you want to. You can go on any Discord server, you can go on any forum online. Don't spam and don't drop in your video links and tell people to come and watch like 50 times and things like that. Go into places where it makes sense, where there's people that would like your content, okay? If you're doing gaming, don't go into a cooking forum, right? People aren't going to be interested in it. Find like-minded individuals in those types of forums online. And there are tons of groups that you can join. And, you know, the Discord server that Ethan runs is awesome. I think there's 13 or 1400 people in it. And you can join, but be part of the conversation, be part of the group. There's a lot of big YouTubers like Daniel Batal and Brian G and a number of others who have awesome groups that you can join online as well. Brian G's Facebook group is like 22,000 people. You know, Daniel Batal has tons of people in his conversation group, right? So join those types of groups and forums. Some of them you do have to pay like a monthly membership to get in, but $5 a month to get, you know, one-on-one time with like tons of other awesome content creators, especially like, you know, Daniel Batal. And I mean, he's such a responsive guy too. He's one of my favorite YouTubers because he will engage with you on tons of stuff too. So I would say, my friend, that the best thing you could do is stick to Google advertising for paid, and for free, really, the sky's the limit. You can just kind of drop your links in and where it fits in with conversations. And there's not really anywhere I wouldn't tell people about my channel, right? Unless it's the niche is 100% different. I have a unique advantage in that my type of niche really applies to everybody's niche in terms of everyone needs YouTube help, right? But if I was running a video game channel, which, you know, if I was going to have another channel, that would be, for me, it would be a gaming channel. I wouldn't be going on like, you know, sites and pages and forums and stuff that make zero sense for me to be there advertising my channel. So I hope that helps, Sandy. The next question comes from Arush the Pro, who asks, anyone want to connect? Yes, Arush, I would love to connect. And this is actually one of my favorite ways to connect right here. Next question. Tara Y asks, where to put questions? So good question, Tara, because Tara, I guess, I didn't explain it well enough in terms of questions getting into these videos. So if you want one of your questions in these videos, these Q&A videos are designed to be all about you guys, all about my audience and helping you with the answers to the questions that you really want. So Tara and anyone else who's interested, it's very simple. All you have to do is put it right in the comments, okay? I go through each video and I actually just snip out all of the comments myself. I save them in a file, and that's how I just pull out questions. I kind of have them written down, and then I know what questions I'm gonna go through for my video. I don't pre-think of answers, so all of this is done essentially on the fly, and it's all just kind of pulled from my knowledge and understanding. And if I ever don't know something, I never pretend like I do, but I'm always the type of person who will do that research for you and help you the best I can and find out, if I possibly can, the answers to your questions. For those of you who have asked questions recently, I actually have a pile of about 20 or 30 more questions. I'm only answering between 3 to 4 or so per video, because as you can see, the videos, even with 3 or 4 questions, can be easily 10, 15, 20 minutes long sometimes. So I don't want to do 5, 6, 7 questions and have the video be too long. I've actually found kind of the sweet spot for me seems to be between around that 11 to maybe 18, 19 minute mark, even 20 minutes. And I will say thank you to each of you who consistently watch and watch to the end of the video, because I've noticed lately, looking at a lot of my analytics, that my click-through rate has been much better lately, especially since my new thumbnail design came in. It's been consistently way higher. And B, the last 4 or 5 videos of mine, the retention, instead of me doing 30, 35 minute long videos where the retention was between 20 to 25%, The retention now has climbed right back up to kind of what it was before. So I've been getting a lot of 30 to 40% retentions on each video. So I want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart to each of you who take the time to do that, to everybody who asks these awesome questions. And if you want your question in one of these videos, just drop a comment, drop your question, leave 2, 3, 4 comments if you want to. I love multiple comments from people. It helps the video get promoted more because the algorithm is registering that lots of engagement is going on. So go ahead and drop in your questions and I will pull them out. I do ask you to be patient because I can't sometimes get to your questions right away. And plus I'm filming other content in between. It's not always a Q&A. Sometimes there's other topics, as well as I am planning on filming a few topics coming up in my older style as well, with the kind of the high energy and that sort of thing, because I've had a lot of requests for that recently as well. So drop comments in, drop your questions in. If you have a specific topic you want to know about, please go ahead and let me know in the comments as well. And you know, let's keep on working together. Let's keep on supporting each other. Let's keep on helping each other grow. If you have not joined the Make Your Mark Facebook group yet, please head over. We've got about 30 members in there. It's small, but they're awesome people. People who support and help each other. Everybody's engaging in there. People jump in and help each other with questions and answers. And we're really trying to get an awesome conversation going there, day in and day out. You know, you don't have to be on there every day, but you know, it's nice when people check in and touch base. And I don't go on every day myself, but I like to check in a few times a week and drop in comments and questions. So we'd love to have you there. And thank you so much for watching the video today. If you want to learn how to be more efficient with your YouTube channel, you want to learn how to grow, make sure you watch one of the videos on the screen. I'm going to have a playlist over here and I'm going to have a regular video over here. And just keep on going. Don't give up. Now is not the time to give up on YouTube. Now is the time to really dig your heels in and push through the challenging struggles that we have. So I want to continue to encourage each and every one of you. And thank you so much for watching. And I'll see all of you in the next video.